saved, we now have a spiritual root, and it will always produce spiritual fruit. So read this with me right now. The old me, let's read this together. This is from Romans 6, 6 and 7. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Now, I don't even care about my old self resting in peace. I know I'm going to live in peace. Yeah. Amen, somebody. I don't care about, oh, old self is dead. Now, the challenge is we keep going back and keep digging up the old self. Just forget, don't put a headstone there, because the old self is dead. And now we are able to live this life. Not just an abundant life, not just an amazing life, not just an anointed life, but a life that is now producing spiritual fruit and not sinful fruit. All that, I'm telling you right now, I lay the foundation to give you this verse. Y'all ready for this verse now? Let's go. Here's Romans, here's 1 John chapter 3, verse 9. Let's go. Whoever is what? Born of God. Born again. Keep going. Does not commit sin. For what? God's seed remains in him. Oh, watch the next part. That's what I'm going to mess you up right now. And he cannot sin because he is born of God. See, this is missing about right here. Y'all with me on the first part. Like, hallelujah, yeah. Hallelujah. I'm born of God. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'm God's seed. So God, born of God, does not commit sin. Because his seed, the nature, the seed, the root, is in us. And he cannot sin because he's born of God. And read this out of context. We could say this verse now contradicts itself. The Bible contradicts itself. Well, let's be clear about who we are. We are a what? Spirit. We possess a what? Soul. We live in a body. What's the body going to do? It's going to be fleshy. Because all that rules the body, it will be the senses, which is smell. You let the body smell something, you're messing the body up. You let the body see something, it's messing the body. The body going to be the body. But what happens, we are a spirit. When we got saved, our spirit became just like Jesus. Glory. So it says in the book of 1 John, as he is, so are we in this world. And so now we look at this and I messed up, I sinned, as a bad thought. Now the spirit man is just like Jesus. So if the flesh, if the body's gonna be the body, and the spirit is now saved, which one is control? Which one is the problem then? The what? The soul. What's the soul again? It's the meow, the kitty cat. It's the what? Mind, emotions, opinion, and will. If our mind is not renewed, we don't let the body rule. Body smell good, let's go. It look good, let's go. But if I go back and renew my mind, I say, oh no, my spirit is just like Jesus. And I know my breakthrough is over there. And my healing is over there. And my trust is over there. And my faith is over there. So now I'm going to let my soul line up with my spirit, and we're going to pull the body along. The body is going to be the body. Don't. The body is just going to do what the body does. The body does the body good. The body is going to just be the body. But what has happened is while we're sinning is because our soul has not been renewed. Please write this down. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. The best thing somebody unsaved can do is to be born again. And the best thing somebody saved can do is to renew our mind. Because my spirit is already just like Jesus. So now, my spirit cannot sin. My spirit cannot lie. My spirit cannot, because my spirit has been renewed. So this whole idea that we heard growing up from church people, all the poor people were blind, talking about when they got saved, I look at my hands and they look new, and I look at the abundance and they did not know the same abundance, same hands before you got saved. It was not your body that got saved. It was the spirit that got saved. And now I'm going to renew my mind to let my mind line up my spirit. And then that's how I can have an abundant life. Yes. But as long as my mind is still not renewed, I'm going to think like I used to think, believe like I used to believe, and wonder why victory has always eluded me. Wonder why fear is always in me, because my mind has not been renewed. But the Holy Spirit is there, that when we get in the Word, that will start renewing our minds and transforming our minds and help us look at different things in our minds. And then when our mind, our soul, lines up with our spirit is already perfect, just like Jesus. But when my spirit, my soul lines up with it, we pull the body along, you just watch, you will not be able to control the amazing and abundant and anointed life God has for you. You won't even be able to recognize the amazing, the abundant, and awesome extraordinary life God has for you. We've been so busy, our minds have kept us, our beliefs, our mind, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. If I think I'm a sinner, I'm going to sin. If I think I'm a failure, I'm a fail. If I think I'm down, I'm down. But if I know I'm victorious, I'm going to live in victory. If I know I walk in favor, I'm going to receive my favor. As a man thinketh it, so our mindset matters. I say our mindset matters. So now, whoever's born of God does not commit sin, because God's seed remains in him, and our spirit cannot sin because it's perfect. So now I got to have my soul, my mind, my emotions, my will line up with my spirit so I can start walking in victory. I'm telling you right now, if there's not victory being seen, it's because the mind has not been renewed. If we're not seeing prosperity in life, it's because our mind has not been renewed. When I line up my mind with what God has already, see, my spirit, God said at this point, my spirit says, God already said, I'm believing, period. Here's the mind over here. I don't know if I believe it or not. Here's the mind. I know I don't believe it. So at some point, I got to go back in and say, I got to have my mind say, no, you know what? No, I do believe it. I do believe it. And after a while, these two will pull that one along. What is happening right now, we allowing our soul to line up with our body. So then all we need is a little hit of channel 5, not Chanel 5, of channel 5 messes up. The idea was because our body has teamed up with our soul going in the wrong direction. And our spirit's over here saying, don't go down there, because I'm telling you, you're going to crash. Come on over here. And our minds have not been renewed. That's why we come to church. That's why we come to Bible study. That's why we study the Word, to get our mind renewed so I can get rid of all this junk and all this dirt residue and all this garbage I've had for years, to now let my mind be renewed to receive what God has for me. So now at this point I can receive everything God has for us as well. So I just want to give you this last point right here. So you got your A on you. We'll pick it over. So you got your A, advocate. So let me tell you, I want to tell God this all right here. Your advocate. Just let the same A be from last week too. So here's what I want to talk about right now. I want to go back and just talk very quickly as we end about our actual confession today. Because we're going to continue to talk and share from John 14 all this entire month here. But so just read this. Read this with me, and I want to end on this last one. So again, so let's read this together. So we know that at this point, you know, that our operating spirit of exceptional excellence. Now let's read this. My advocate, who is that?
Holy Spirit
helps me overcome the adversary. Keep going.
And
some adversity.
Oh.
Keep going. And gives me the advantage. The Holy Spirit is going to help you overcome the adversity. Holy Spirit helps me overcome the adversary. And the Holy Spirit gives me the advantage. We already talked about the advocate last week. It's talking about somebody that's talking, we said already, it's somebody that supports you, somebody who upholds, somebody who has your back, basically. This is the best, this is what the Holy Spirit does. When we're down, Holy Spirit, I'm right here to pick you up. Everybody else can walk away, Holy Spirit's already there to pick you up. Everybody else can say that you're no good, Holy Spirit's right there. They can have you on Snapchat, they can have you on Instagram, show you did wrong. Holy Spirit's still right there trying to lift you up. Right there trying to lift you up. That's an advocate for you. Now what does he do now? The advocate does in this case, we talk about now the adversary. Who's the adversary? The devil. Read this with me right there. 1 Peter 5:8. Read this together. Be sober, not drunk. Be vigilant. Keep going. Because your adversary, who? The devil. As a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. So God, already by the power of the Holy Spirit, has already helped me overcome the adversary. So why do I know that? John 10:10. Please read this with me. Amplified Classic. The thief. Who's the thief? Also the adversary. So let's put adversary where it says thief. The adversary comes on. Or is he called? To steal and kill and destroy. Keep going. Jesus says, I came that they may have and enjoy life and have it in abundance to the full, to the overflow. Anybody ready to start enjoying life like that? To abundance, to the full, and the overflow. So the adversary, so we know why the adversary is coming. But Jesus, I've already gone in and given you a picture of it. So the advocate has to overcome the adversary and all adversity. What do you say all the time? Read this with me. I am revolutionary. Why? I overcome some obstacles. All obstacles, Christ. And what's adversity? It's just simply difficulty. Jesus says right here, the Holy Spirit has been sent to help you overcome any hardship in your life. Any difficulty. I don't care how big that mountain is, the Holy Spirit can help you through it. I don't care what's going on in your life. The Holy Spirit is there to help us overcome all hardship, all pain. He'll wipe away your tears when it doesn't look good, when you're down in the valley, when it's going ready to turn back. The Holy Spirit is there to say, I'm going to help you overcome all adversity in life. So here's what happens. Adversity, difficulties. Adversary, enemy. Adverse, bad. Watch what happens now. Adversity can make us strong. I'm telling you right now, there are some of us in here who have gone through and have come on the other side. You went through the fire, and you don't even smell like smoke. You are stronger now than you were before. Amen. There's some folk right here who went through the valley and recognize I'm going through the valley. I'm not going to stay in the valley. And now you're on the mountain. You are stronger than you were before. There's some folks that went through the water and it did not drown you. And you came out even better because you're stronger right now. If we don't give up in adversity, we become stronger and better and wiser because the Holy Spirit always is there to see us through. Can somebody give God one more hand kind of praise? He's always there to raise us up and see us through. So lastly, we'll conclude on this one. What's the last part say? My advocate does what? Gives me the advantage. I love that one. I love that one. Read that with me, please. The Holy Spirit is your advantage. That's why when you are in a meeting with folk who are not saved, you got some insight they don't have. Because you got the Holy Spirit. Come on, somebody. I'm not saying you're better. But praise God, you got an advantage there. Believers have an advantage, an unseen partner who's always there to lead us and always there to guide us and always there to prompt us. We now have an advantage because of the Holy Spirit. Oh, come on now, read this with me. The Holy Spirit gives you an advantage. I don't care what the score is. I don't care what it looks like. You already have the advantage. When you got born again, when we surrender to the Lord and submit to Him and find ourselves to come to Him, we always have the advantage. I don't care what you're going through. You have the advantage. I don't care how bad it looks. You have the advantage. I don't care where you want to give up. You have the advantage. I'm telling you right now, you have, I have, believers have the advantage through the Holy Spirit. We have the Holy Spirit advantage. I'm telling you, you ever had a situation and you've been trying to figure this problem out and you've been trying to figure this thing out and you say, God, I just need your help right now and get instant results. You got the Holy Spirit. I'm telling you, believers are blessed to have the advantage that non-believers don't have. We have the Holy Spirit, the same power that raised Jesus from the dead. The same power that spoke to Jesus in the wilderness. The same power is in you and in me. And we have the advantage. Can somebody just give God a hand clap of praise for the fact that we have the advantage in Jesus' name?